Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. Welcome to Amazed by the Quran, a series in which I like to share with you things I find amazing about the Quran. And today, inshallah, it sounds geeky, but I'll talk to you about the difference between singular and plural in the Quran, and actually sometimes different kinds of plurals in the Quran, which, yeah, it sounds grammatical, but I'll make sure that it's easy to understand. Our first case is actually a description of Judgment Day. Allah says about people who are lamenting on Judgment Day. They're about to be thrown into devastation. They didn't make it to heaven. And they're saying, فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ. We don't have people that are going to make a case for us. We don't have any friend that is intimate and close. Now in this language, the first group that they complain they don't have in their favor, on their side, is شَافِعِينَ, which is plural. People who will make a case for us. And then they say, we don't have a single friend that is close to us. Sadiqin Hamim, an intimate, close friend. So they go from people who will make a case for us, which is plural, to a single friend, which is really powerful because, you know, if you ask around somebody, hey, what do you think of this person? They're all right, they're cool. You know, it's, you can find lots of people that are okay with you. You know, they don't know you well enough and they seem like a good person. That's a shafi'. That's someone who came and said, yeah, you know what, you're not that bad. But then to find someone who's close and intimate and knows you deeply well and then cares about your well-being and stops and tries to plead on your behalf that please don't let him go into the hellfire and, you know, I'll vouch for him, etc. Those are not going to be a lot of people. There's not a single one, right? So the ones you tend to have many of, the plural is used. And the ones that are, maybe if you find one, even if you could just find one, that would mean a lot, the singular is used. So this is an immediate switch from the plural to the singular. It's very powerful and beautiful. فَمَا لَنَا مِنْ شَافِعِينَ وَلَا صَدِيقٍ حَمِيمٍ. In doing so, Allah didn't just describe something that happens on Judgment Day. As a matter of fact, He described the nature of relationships. You know, casual relationships where people have good opinion of you are lots of them. There's acquaintances that think highly of you or think okay of you. They don't have a poor opinion of you. They're shafi'. You know, but then to have people vouch for you that are the closest, most intimate friends, that's actually a testimony of character. Because people that are very, very close to you, they know your flaws. They don't just know the good things about you, right? And so when they speak highly of you, that's actually, it means something. It actually genuinely means something that when they speak highly of you. So that's kind of a subtle lesson that's taught just by the switch between the plural and the singular. Another example of the plural and the singular that I find really beautiful is actually about, again, the Day of Judgment, where there's a comparison made between heaven and hell. And in describing heaven, Allah says, يُدْخِلْهُ جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا. So it begins with, whoever would obey Allah and the Messenger, which is singular, whoever would obey Allah and His Messenger, وَمَنْ يُطِعِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ, he will enter him, all singular, enter him, not enter them, enter him, جَنَّاتٍ تَجْرِي مِنْ تَحْتِهَا الْأَنْهَارِ, in gardens at the bottoms of which, even at the bottoms, from the very bottoms of which rivers flow, خَالِدِينَ فِيهَا, in which they will remain forever. So he will be entered, he will enter him into the garden, but they will remain in it forever. خَالِدِينَ, it's an immediate switch. And if you compare this to the next ayah, وَمَنْ يَعْصِ اللَّهَ وَرَسُولَهُ وَيَتَعَدَّ حُدُودَهُ يُدْخِلْهُ نَارًا خَالِدًا فِيهَا. Whoever would disobey Allah and His Messenger and cross the limits that they've set, he will enter him into a fire in which he will remain. So there's they will remain, and then there's he will remain. Immediate switch, right? So, and what's really fascinating even about the first one is, it started with he. Like, he will enter this person into heaven where they will remain. So it went from he to they. And the second one was he, and then still remains he. So I want you to appreciate this switch that happened, especially when talking about heaven. Allah is describing the scenario of someone who didn't have much company in this life. Perhaps because of their faith, they were left alone. Perhaps because of their faith, everybody around them abandoned them. Their family disowned them. Their friends left away from them, you know? And maybe because even if they were around Muslims, they were the only one who took their Islam seriously or something. And as a result, they felt isolated. They felt pushed away from other people, you know? And these are people who did not let go of their commitment to good deeds and obedience to Allah and His Messenger, regardless of the pressure that came, regardless of the isolation that they felt. And Allah, one of the first gifts He gives them when He enters them into the Garden of Heaven, in Jannah, is that they're in company. They're never going to be alone again. They will remain. So Allah actually puts them in the plurality. He gives them a new family. He gives them company. Things that they lost out on, missed out on as a result of their Islam and as a result of their submission, subhanAllah. Also additionally, the subtlety here is that we're being told that one of the joys of heaven is company. One of the joys of Jannah is actually friends hanging out with each other, talking to each other. فَأَقْبَلَ بَعْضُهُمْ عَلَى بَعْضٍ يَتَسَاءَلُونَ They're going to be facing one another, asking each other all kinds of questions. Man, where you been? Haven't seen you forever. Wow, you made it too, huh? Like, things like that. But you know, they'll be asking each other, hanging out. They're going to be reminiscing about old times. إِنَّا كُنَّا قَبْلُ فِي أَهْلِنَا مُشْفِقِينَ Man, we used to have such a hard time with our families, man. Like, literally, there are ayat like that in the Quran. Like, they're reminiscing about old times. And that's one of the joys of heaven. On the other end, though, Allah is describing the disbeliever, no matter how much he thinks he has company, no matter how many people he or she surrounds themselves with, no matter how many people are dancing around with them in the club, they're actually always alone. They never genuinely have someone with them, a relationship that will last, you know? Especially, it's not just any disbeliever, the one who violates the laws of Allah and His Messenger. You know, we're not just talking about any non-Muslims here. We're talking about culprits who go out of their way to disobey Allah and His Messenger. They take the one thing that will give them peace. They never find peace in other people's company. They just don't. They're always out only for themselves. And then what happens, one of the torments of hell for them is that they are in it and they feel like they're the only one in it. You know, one of the worst kinds of prison even in this world is solitary confinement. It's like, prison itself is torture, but on top of that, the solitude and the loneliness that you are that is imposed on you for months on end, you lose track of time, people lose their sanity as a result, you know? And that's actually the feeling these people get. There's not even the consolation, at least I'm not the only one being burned. At least I'm not the only one being punished. No, it's not like that. They're gonna feel like they're the only one. خَالِدًا فِيهَا وَلَهُ عَذَابٌ مُهِينٌ And he will have humiliating punishment. May Allah not make us from those who are punished, you know? So these are just a couple of quick examples of the singular and the plural and how these quick switches create such beautiful lessons and such powerful insights. Barakallahu li wa lakum. Assalamu alaikum. See you next time.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullah. If you enjoyed this video, please do share it with friends and family. If you want to see more videos from this series, click on the box at the top. If you want to see other videos, click on the box at the bottom. And don't forget to hit the subscribe button. Thanks.